Think about buying a home this year? Don't know where to start? Have questions that you need answers to? This is the James Dwyer Show. Hey, everybody, and welcome to episode 24 of the James Dwyer Show, a show dedicated to providing you with tips and advice on buying your first home. Today's topic is be cautious as a first-time home buyer when dealing with listing agents, or also known as selling agents, the agents that represent the homes that you're going to go look at. Think about it this way. When you start the process, all of a sudden you'll start seeing everywhere. Contact me now to see this property. You'll see it in on realtor.ca. You'll see it on Viewpoint. You'll see it in Facebook ads. You'll see it in newspaper ads. You will see it everywhere. Contact me now to view this property. Now, the common misconception is that, well, although they are there to help broker the deal, what you need to know is this. The seller's agent or the listing agent is fundamentally paid by the seller to get the best price and to get the best terms, which is also equally as important. Take, for example, say you do make an offer and you know you feel comfortable that you can represent yourself. Well, chances are you're going to be focused on the price a lot. But do you know what is an adequate amount of money to put down for, say, a deposit? Or do you know how to negotiate the findings from your home inspection? Say there was issues with the house and you don't know how to address them. Or even better yet, what about additional inspections that go beyond the scope of a home inspection? Say things like radon tests or having the sewer line scoped. Do you know how to put those in place so that you're going to be protected? Now, with that being said, I'm not saying that listing agents or selling agents are out there to take advantage of you, and they're really not. But you just have to understand where the money's going. And that fundamentally is the seller's agent or listing agent is being paid by the seller to get the best terms and price. So what I would recommend to you is it costs absolutely nothing to hire an agent, a real estate agent, to represent you. And think about it this way. The buyer's agent or your agent is there fundamentally to create a buffer between you, the seller's agent, and the seller so that you're going to be protected and you won't give up such information that could be, you know, have an impact on your offer. So I hope you found today's question and answer of value to you today. And if you have a question, feel free to get at me in social. You can contact me here on Facebook, Twitter, or Snapchat. Once again, I'm James Dwyer, and thank you for watching.